Hello creators and welcome to CLO3D. If it's your first time here, you will see this workspace. I use CLO 7.0, but UI didn't change across versions. First of all, let's open the avatar. We have a library on the left panel. CLO provides us with different objects, avatars, fabrics, hardware and trims that you can load and use in your scene. Let's go to the avatar folder, open the female version 2, and choose the one you like. Double-click to load it to your scene. You'll see it in a 3D window. We can also import a custom avatar in one of these formats, but today we'll stick to the basic one. You can move or pan the view in both 3D and 2D windows by pressing the middle mouse button. Rotate the view with the right mouse button. And zoom in, zoom out by moving the wheel on your mouse or by holding the Alt and left mouse button. Also, there are useful shortcuts for the front view. It's number 2, side views number 4 and 6, and back view number 8. CLO3D provides us with the basic t-shirts in a garment folder. Let's open the first one. We have this window because we open a garment that was created for the same avatar. We can open it or open and change the size and pose for the avatar so it fits this garment. This shirt was created for the same size and pose avatar, so we won't see the difference. Now you can see the t-shirt arranged around the avatar in the 3D window and t-shirt patterns in a 2D window. Most of the time we will create, edit, sew and texture patterns in a 2D window and simulate them on the avatar in a 3D window. These multicolor lines are sewing lines or seams. We add them to sew edges and pieces together. Now let's press space to turn on the simulation and check how it works. Tweak the fabric. CLO3D uses CPU simulation by default. It's a solid color arrow called normal simulation. Click and hold and you will see other options. Select fast GPU simulation if you have an NVIDIA graphics card on your computer. It's much faster than CPU, especially in complicated clothes with a lot of fabric. But it's not as accurate as CPU. It doesn't simulate layers of fabric and seams correctly. Usually I create and edit patterns with the GPU, and when it's time to add layers or simulate fabric precisely, I switch to CPU. There is one more type called fitting, but it's slow and usually used for making animations. Then we have different tools in 3D and 2D toolbars. Actually, I like to move them to the top and free space for 3D and 2D windows. You can go to Settings, User Settings, User Interface, and change the toolbar location to the top. By the way, while we are here, you can also change the buttons for moving the view in the View Control Settings. For example, there are presets for 3ds Max and Maya. Here we go, that's much better. You will use these tools 90% of the time. These ones are for creating and editing patterns, and these are for adding sewing lines, texturing, and adding top stitches. Most of them have shortcuts that I highly recommend you to use. Hover the mouse on the tools and you will see them. Actually, all the essential tools have shortcuts. Let's learn how to use them by creating a simple garment, a circular skirt. First of all, we select and move patterns with A, Transfer Pattern tool. I use shortcuts, so if you miss something, check what I press here. If you want to select the line, point or the edge, use Z, Edit Pattern tool. To create a new pattern from the shape, you can use these tools. Click and hold on the icon, and there are Polygon, Rectangle, Ellipse and Spiral tools. We need to draft an ellipse for our circle skirt, so select it or press E on a keyboard and left-click somewhere in a 2D window. Here you need to type the dimensions for the skirt. You can choose the diameter, radius or circumference. I'd like to make the radius about 50 cm, 50 by 50, and press OK. It appeared in a 2D window and in a 3D window as well. Now let's add a hole at the center. It should be the avatar's waist circumference, about 60 cm for this avatar. But if you don't know this value, you can measure it. Let's hide the t-shirt for now so we can see the avatar's body. Select Patterns and press Shift Q. Now find measurement tools in a 3D toolbar. They are here. Yeah, the top location for the toolbar is a bit tight, but we can move them to the left. We won't use these tools anyway. Actually, I don't use, I think, 80% of the 3D tools. We can draw the measurement line with the basic circumference measure tool and check its length with the edit measure tool. As we already have some measures here, let's just check the length. Click on the line and it's 61 centimeters. So these tools are quite useful to understand the dimensions of patterns you need to create. To quit this measures view, press Q, select Move Tool. It's an analog to a transform pattern tool for the 3D window. Let's move on and add a hole to our skirt. Select the internal ellipse tool here or press R. Move the cursor until it snaps to the center of the ellipse. Left click and type the circumference value, 60 centimeters. Now we need to convert this ellipse to a hole. Select it. When you select, the object becomes yellow. Right-click on it and you will see a context menu with a bunch of actions, describing what you can do with the selected line or object. We need to convert it into a hole. Here we go. We'll use context menu very frequently. Different objects have different actions. For example, if you right-click on a pattern, you will see other actions. Some of them have shortcuts that you can use instead of opening this menu. Now let's place the skirt in a 3D window. Select it and you will see a gizmo tool. We can move an object with red, green and blue arrows. Also, we can move it without the gizmo by dragging an object. We can rotate it with circles of the same colors. For example, I will move the camera in such a position and rotate the green circle. You can notice that the skirt is rotating relative to the camera view. It can be quite tricky to place an object in a 3D window this way, because you rotate it, think that it looks good, rotate the camera and see that it's not. You can change the gizmo type in Preferences, Gizmo, and choose Local or World Coordinates. Let's select World Coordinates. Now it's much easier to rotate an object because it's rotating relative to the world origin. However, we have more arrows, circles and squares here, and I usually misclick on them. That's why I like to use the Screen Coordinates gizmo and rotate the object when I'm in front, side, back and top views, using shortcuts. It's number 5 for the top view, by the way. Try all these gizmos and choose one that is convenient for you. The skirt goes through the arms, but it's not a big problem. Now let's make a waistband. Use S, rectangle tool for this, and left-click in a 2D window. Type the measurements. The width should be 60 cm at the waist circumference. The height is about 3-4 cm. You can also press Enter instead of the OK button. So how can we place this pattern? We have very useful arrangement points for this avatar. Press Shift-F to show them. Or find it here. We can place a waistband on one of these central points and it will be located around the avatar. We can even place it on this point to have it closer to the skin and move it up. Great. Shift F to hide the points. Now we need to sew it to our skirt. We have a few sewing tools here and very useful shortcuts B, N, M. I prefer using N segment sewing tool in most cases because it's quick and easy. Just click on the edges to add sewing lines. But you can only sew segments between two segment points this way. There is also M, free segment tool. You need to select the first and the last point to make a sewing line. As you can see, it takes more time to add the seam, but you can make a sewing line ignoring the segment points. Nevertheless, I still prefer using the segment sewing tool, even with the segment points on my way. Let's see where we need to start the sewing. There are no seams on the skirt, so it's hard to understand where to start. If you click on the pattern in a 3D window, you will see where you clicked in a 2D window. There will be a blue dot. So we need to start here and go this way. Now select N, segment sewing tool, and click on the bottom edge of the waistband, so the notch will be on the left. It's an indicator of the sewing line direction. Then press and hold Shift and select all the edges on our skirt one by one. Make sure that all the notches are also on the left. Finally, release Shift. Here we go. Easy! Sew the center back line. You can sew it in a 3D window as well, but it's not convenient for me. If you have crossed lines, it means that one of the sewing lines had the wrong direction. Select it with B, Edit Sewing Tool, right-click, and select Reverse Sewing. Simulate once you're done. Pull it out from hands. And I forgot that we have a t-shirt here. Select patterns and show them with Shift Q. I want to place the skirt on top of the shirt. Instead of trying to pull it out, we can say CLO to make it for us. Select the skirt. We have a property editor on the right panel. It contains different properties for the selected object. When we select the pattern, we have the simulation properties here. I would better call them pattern properties because they are for patterns, and selected line properties are for lines. Anyways, there is one interesting option called layer. If we set it to 1 or any other number bigger than 0, CLO3D will push the garment on top of the others. So simulate and check it. It doesn't work because I use GPU simulation at the moment. As I said, it doesn't work great with layers, so change it to CPU. Here we go. Now change the layer back to 0. So that's how we can use tools for pattern making. Now let's learn about materials. This is an object browser with all the objects and materials you use in your scene. Fabrics, graphics, buttons, buttonholes, and so on. For example, we have a default fabric for our clothes. We can change it and select one of the CLO provided us in the library. I will select knit jersey for the t-shirt. You can drag and drop it to the pattern or to the object browser. And then select patterns and drag and drop it to them. Also, I will choose leather for the skirt. Here it is. Simulate and see the difference. All these fabrics have basic textures, but you can change them in the property editor. Select the fabric in the object browser. Each fabric has material properties that are responsible for its appearance. We can plug in different PBR texture maps and slightly adjust them. Also, we can change the color by clicking on this square and change the material type to one of these. For example, to silk or velvet. We can also use substance materials. Change PBR to substance here and open the SBSAR file. The next properties are physical, which are responsible for the behavior during the simulation. Each fabric from the library has the same name physical properties preset. For example, we have a leather preset for the leather fabric. You can change it and select one of these, or open the details section and adjust it manually. In addition to these fabrics, CLO also have an integration with the CLO Connect store, and you can access it from the library. Click on this icon and log in to your account. If you don't have an account, go to the website, click on the next icon and create an account, and then log in here. You can download different free objects and fabrics here, or buy them on the website and find them in My Items. Let's download and use another fabric for the skirt. For example, this one. Drag and drop it instead of the leather. Yeah, it looks great, and I think it's really convenient. Finally, you may notice that our garments aren't very detailed, because they have large polygons. Each object is a mesh created from polygons. You can change the material type to the mesh here and check it. These triangles are polygons. The smaller they are, the more detailed objects we have. Select all the patterns and go to the property editor. We have the particle distance setting. I believe it's a polygon size value. Let's decrease it and see what happens. The polygons became smaller. Switch to the thick texture surface mode and simulate. The folded wrinkles became smoother, but we need to decrease polygons even more to get a better realistic result. Usually you set the smaller values at the end of the work when you are ready to render or export your garment, because it really slows down the simulation. Particle distance 5 looks good for me. And that's basically it for today. We learned the basics of CLO, now you need to start making clothes. It was the first part of the CLO3D Beginner's Guide. Click on the full playlist here or check the link in the description. See you in the next videos. Bye!